Hi, it's Mary Thompson with Mr. Reuter and the Dwyer Group. I am so excited to be heading to Haiti. Derek Moreland and Satish from 3M and Chris Amoyan are going with me, and we're going to make a difference. Tomorrow should be a really interesting day because we are going to be planes, trains, and automobiles pretty much. We fly into Santiago, Dominican Republic tonight, and then tomorrow morning we're going to catch a bus and we're going to take it to a little town right at the border of Haiti called Quantamith, and where we'll meet up with the people from Mission Waco who have been just wonderful all this. They've really been a big help. And then we're going to go down to a little town just north of Port-au-Prince and look at their plumbing, and we have our master plumber, Derek Moreland, who's going to look and see what needs to be done so we can bring back a group of franchisees back to really finish the work. And it's so exciting to be able to make a difference and be able to take our talents and help others. We're on the bus to Dakar, and it's a little bumpy.
We crossed the border through, there was a huge open air market, and it was quite a harrowing experience. Thousands and thousands of people. And somebody stole my wallet in the crowd. I mean, everybody was bustling together.
We got a flat tire on our way to Port-au-Prince about 50 kilometers into the trip. We have another 200 kilometers to go. The roads have been filled with potholes and very dusty, and we're just looking forward to making it to Port-au-Prince. We're keeping optimistic.
Cross country has been an awesome experience. It let us see the little towns, the big towns, and the little villages. And my one word answer is, it's like India. It's exactly like India, except for the big cities do not have the shine and glamour of the big cities in India. Then the rest of them, small towns are exactly the same, and the villages are exactly the same.
Well, you know what, it's just heartbreaking to see these people. You know, I guess when the earthquake hit, everything they owned, everything they had, gone in it and finished, and now they're crammed in this tent city, and it's just pure squalor. I'm really struggling to put into words what this whole thing looks like and how it feels.
I can't even begin to describe the poverty, the kind of poverty that you don't even believe exists. We were driving along yesterday. As we got closer and closer to Layagon, that's really the epicenter of where the earthquake hit. When we got there, you started seeing sides of buildings that had fallen down and rubble in the road and just whole buildings just literally in a pile on the ground.
Yeah, it's quite a wake-up call when you see what's going on here and the people. You know, you just can't imagine what they have had to go through in these tent cities. They've been stuck there for, I think, 5 months, and I'm not sure when they'll ever get out of there. But it just shows you how fortunate we are.
When the earthquake hit, we actually tried to put together a system that could be shipped to the site. We could purify the water and then, like, just for emergency relief. We could not do it at the time. So, and then this opportunity came up that that you are working with Mission Waco to see what we could do to Haiti. And
here's recording. And now you want to sample.
Actually, I'm going to take a sample off of this one.
Oh, okay.
I just did like two.
We could start bagging this chlorinated water that the women, especially with children under the age of 5, would have clean water in their homes, and that would change the health of their babies, but also to provide chlorinated clean water for the whole village. And then the next idea was maybe to make a micro enterprise out of this so that some of the women could start selling clean water so that they could be getting a little bit of the profits so that they could feed their babies and send them to school and maybe get a tin roof and maybe have a hygienic toilet someday. And so we've invested in three of these, one to keep in the state so I can train people there and show them what we're doing over here. And then two are here, and we're taking one down with us to Port-au-Prince when we go. If children have survived past the age of 5, they're not getting as sick. But the babies, if you keep giving those babies that water and they keep having diarrhea, they will die. And it's one of the fastest killers. 80% of the diseases in the world come from bad water.
Has anyone in her family been sick in the last 30 days?
Pas un monde dans famille qui malade pour les derniers temps ça.
Oui, mon petit monde qui malade.
She has one of her child who's sick now.
How old is that child?
Quel âge?
Okay. And where do they get their drinking water from?
Qui côté nous vient de l'eau pour nous boire?
Là.
Là.
And have they experienced any sicknesses in the last month?
Nous pas expérimenté aucune maladie pendant les derniers mois ça qui s'est passé là. Y a pas malade ou bien nous même nous pas malade?
Y a malade, nous sommes malades.
Ou même tout?
Des fièvres, grippe.
Tout.
Oui, tout.
Yeah, they have fevers and colds, you know.
Has anyone in your family been sick in the last month?
Oui, mon enfant qui malade pendant.
Oui.
Children are sick now. Have fevers, diarrhea, and headaches.
In your stomach?
Oui, mon enfant.
Là, mon maquem.
Like, stomach.
Papa. Papa.
She is very pretty.
Did you
need
that
appeal? Yeah. My daughter. And my son. So this is one of their wells. They can't use this for drinking water, but they use this to wash their clothes in and for dishes, which probably makes them sick some of the time. Would you tell her if we can, we'd like to test this well?
So
it doesn't make you sick.
Pour pas faire nous malade.
OK?
I am showing people how to make their own water filter.
So these you're going to leave with everyone here?
And they're going to decide which family with babies under 5 get the first 5 that are complete.
This was a very neat way of making two-stage filtration. It took probably 15 minutes to make a filter, and it costs about $20 total.
Our goal is to find out where they're drinking water, where they're getting it. We're going to test the well or wells, whatever's around. We're going to test the river. We're going to kind of cause a little bit of a scene so that the people are going to be curious about why we're there.
We tested the water for bacteria.
Mm-hmm.
The pump looks okay, even though the test method is a little questionable. But for sure that the river is really bad.
And the moms that are nursing, they're supplementing the nursing with water.
With water.
And it's making
so
the babies really sick.
We're testing this water, and if this turns out
it's
to be a little bit contaminated.
It's bad.
Okay. They need to use the artesian well.
But drinking. Do not drink. Okay, can you tell her about the boiling water? That okay. Is very important. Thank you. Merci.
Oui.
Merci.
Considering what they've been through, you know, we complain about things like, you know, the world is not perfect for us, and they have this horrible, horrible place that they're living in, and they're happy.
The people are fantastic, very friendly, especially the kids. The kids just love having visitors here and playing games. I think if I had to describe how I feel so far, it's humbling. Like, you know, we have got so much at home. Like, I can't name everything, but you know what, the people here have nothing, but they're just so happy.
People deserve a lot more, especially these young kids. They are wonderful, wonderful children, fun to play with. They give love a lot, and expect nothing in return.
They reminded me that you really don't need material things to make you happy. You need people and love in your life, and they really showed that.
There's a Haitian proverb called mountains beyond mountains. The idea is just beyond this mountain, there's another one and another one. We're going to have problems, but let's keep working together. That's a spiritual concept. That's a character trait of God.
Every single person that I ran into was polite and gentle and kind and more than willing to share. We need to go back there and finish helping them. So this needs to be a beginning and not an end, but a beginning.